Gather round, travelers and rogues. Gather round and bear witness to the story of El Man at Arms. His fable began not so long ago, in amidst a group of gypsy travelers. One day, when they were away pilfering what they could from the nearest village, our to-be hero strayed from his carriage. Being young and inexperienced, he accidentally let the tide grab him. And so the hand of fate held him tight and thrust El Man at Arms into an unknown future. This fateful tide eventually washed El Man at Arms up in the docks of Irilla. Luckily for our hero, two knights were passing by and pledged to foster the stray Man at Arms as their brother. El Man at Arms appreciated their help and good deed, but could not bear their jests and taunts as they sneered at his scrawniness. Their laughter was unbearable. Suddenly, an idea shot through the curly cabbage known as a brain of El Man at Arms. He would live up to his name and slay the infamous Mason Bull. The voyage was long and grueling, yet our nimble traveler made it at last. However, his journey was not over yet. A steep ascent to a treacherous path through ruins of an old fort still awaited. This was no obstacle for the determined man-at-arms, who swiftly made haste to the lair of the Mason Bull. And there it stood, massive and menacing. A bull of such size it would frighten any man with at least half his wits. Yet El Man at Arms showed no fear. El Man at Arms focused. El Man at Arms dodged and struck and did his best. In the end, he was bested by this wretched bull, forced to succumb to the immense power of his foe. It took El Man at Arms quite some time to regain his strength. He traveled the world in shame and in search of a mentor who might help him hone his skills. Whispers reached our hero's ears. Wretched whispers of a foul and cursed place which may hold just what the man-at-arms was searching for. And so he traveled through the dark forest, hoping he would still live at the end of this excursion. At last, El Man-at-Arms reached the haunted fort. No man had entered the fort and left with his life. Yet this was a risk that had to be taken. To the dismay of our hero, the fort had been walled off entirely. He stood in front of a vast stretch of the wooden palisade, and suddenly heard a booming voice.
"You are worthy,"
it claimed, as it made way for the man at arms. A black figure loomed over him from a rocky outcrop ahead. A wizard, no less, no more. He became the mentor of El Man at Arms, teaching him how to bend the very fabrics of reality. With his newly acquired knowledge, El Man at Arms returned to the bull's lair, this time confident the battle would tide differently. The bull charged once again, but this time El Man at Arms was swifter and beyond any chiropractor's expectations. A whirlwind of blows beyond count landed as the man-at-arms spun and twisted, graceful as a ballerina. The bull had no chance. Perhaps his frames per second were too few. his blocks too late for insta-hits, or field of view insufficient. Whatever it was, the bull fell as El-Man-At-Arms triumphed. After his spectacular victory, El-Man-At-Arms gained recognition and praise beyond his wildest dreams. He was even crowned king and reigned over the realm, proving his fostered brothers wrong, as they secretly admired his fabulous power. And that is the end of the story of El-Man-At-Arms, the Gypsy Ballerina King.
Oh, you died in front of my kick. Oh my god. I hope we didn't rush the record here because your body is like hitting the rock. It's so funny to see you just pushing the gun so hard, screaming. It makes it so crazy. Oh, damn it. A simple drag.